Okay. So we will be covering S/4HANA finance configuration. We will be covering overview of CFIN. We will be covering the architecture with SAP and non-SAP, and then we will be doing a hands-on config. And the configuration starts right from implementation of OSS nodes in ECC. Then we will do S/4HANA finance config on a S/4 side, and then in SLT, and then we will connect all the three systems, ECC, S/4, SLT. And once the configuration is complete, we will do CFIN IMG configurations. I will share the mappings, how to set up, how to use, and then initial load, real-time replication will be done, and we will resolve errors with the offer data from AIF. And then we will go to central payment, we'll implement nodes for central payment. So that would be the objective of this training. It completely hands-on. You'll be responsible right from, you will be getting task of CFIN configuration of ECC node support, supporting team to implement OSS nodes, a screen SLT. I will cover SLT configurations of connecting systems. I will cover putting filters in SLT, which is important, how to bring data, how to stop data. And then we will see up and running system. So as I said, this training is not something you are only just looking at a PowerPoint. Any PowerPoint will not be used except session one. That's the only PowerPoint we will use. Other than that, there is no PowerPoint. We are just working on the systems. We have all the three systems available. You will get access on day one. Even before joining the training, you will get access, and you will be working hands-on. Detailed training content, of course, this is a summary. Everything is mentioned on the link here, which I can share after the meeting. So this is the course content which we are going to talk about. About me, before I jump on to the course actual content, I know a lot of you people know me through YouTube, LinkedIn. I am already sharing a lot of information on CFIN from on internet. And yeah, I have done five large central finance programs already. And recently SAP Press recommended to follow me for central finance. So they honor me with this very recently. Yeah, because I'm sharing a lot of content on internet for central finance. So you have a lot of information available already, but yet this is, I never came up with any hands-on thing. So this time this will be a hands-on training. Moving on, a very first thing which everybody asks is, what is the fees and what is inclusion, what is exclusion? So you will get, I'll come to fees in a couple of minutes. The training goes for 5 weeks, 40 hours training. We do 4 hour Saturday, 4 hour Sunday. Training goes for 5 weeks and plus 30 days, you will get system access. You will have dedicated servers are there. You will get ECC, SLT, S/4HANA. All sessions are recorded. You will get the link to all the sessions. You will get the PDF material, S4F04, S4F60, S4F61, and lot of other books to read, along with lot of other guides which are not available on public domain, which we will be sharing soon. And of course, certification guidance, how to clear, what can be the possible questions, what to read, how to prepare. So as I said, it is not a project. It is not a training. It is a project you will be doing end to end. And the fees is 57,500 INR or 770 USD, depending on which country you belong to. Reason is, a lot of people came that this is too costly because servers are very costly. We are not just showing on PowerPoint. I can prepare PowerPoint and show you that screenshot, which I already have a lot of documents, but servers getting systems up and running, implementing 400 OSS nodes on ECC system is a marathon task. So you will get that up and running and ready. You will be supporting that cause. So we have a dedicated basis team involved in this activity. And of course, recording material, there is nothing to worry about. And of course, and the way we engage is the batch one is already there. So we engage is we create a WhatsApp group. The entire batch is part of the group and we communicate even offline, you know, after the training. It's not that we just meet once a week. We communicate offline that, okay, how guys, what is going with the notes? Okay, I am doing this configuration. I have done created company codes. Can you create number range? So it's like off and on kind of project goes on for 5 weeks. Yeah. This is how the agenda looks like. And feel free to drop in the chat any question you have till now. Of course, if something more comes, we will cover that. So this is how the agenda is. Very busy agenda for 5 weeks. So as I said, you will spend some time offline as well. You will be doing CFIR architecture, concept, limitations. First session is all theory. And then we go to write immediately from session two, S/4HANA system configurations, SLT and ECC system configuration. Then we do initial load, replication. And of course, when we do initial load, we come do mappings. We upload all the mappings through standard programs. We do key mapping, value mapping. And then, of course, in the last part, we do central payments and we talk about certification, reporting, reconciliations between 4 and 5. So that's how the agenda and planning looks like in terms of how are we dividing. So it's a very busy time, these 5 weeks. You will not be just engaged for 8 hours of training a week, but rather than also you will be working together closely with the group. So it's a kind of project team and you work into it. Any point you have want to raise or any doubt you have so that we clear that out. No? Okay.
You can see in the chat.
Okay, I think I have some. Yeah. How much time weekly? So the question, during weekends, we take session 4 hours on Saturday, 4 hours on Sunday. And during the week, it is up to you how much you can debate. For example, there is a activity of creation of company code and basic FI configuration, which you might be able to do in 2 hours. So during the week, you can sit for 2 hours on your system offline. You don't need to come to the sessions. It is offline, but we collaborate through WhatsApp group to the entire group. So then somebody next will start after you do, somebody next will start creating number range and creating some master data. Yeah. So that's how we do.
Nitin, just wanted to ask, like, you know, what sort of S4 configuration, what is going to be structure of that? Is it just company code and then related GL configuration? Then, are we going to also cover the other, areas like intercompany transactions, the various recurring postings that is going to take place with the various cost centers? What about the financial reporting? Are we also going to cover the financial reporting, formats and the parameters applicable for publishing the financial statements in a particular reporting format?
Yes. We will cover everything. We will be covering intercompany. So in the current scenario, we are creating 2 company codes. We will be covering intercompany transactions as well, how to eliminate those, how to work on mappings and everything for those 2 company codes. Yes, so there is a scope of covering intercompanies as well as when we will do the configurations, you will not be just doing a core company code and just go away. No, the intention is company code, of course, all GL configuration, AR configuration, AP configuration. And when I say AR, AP means payment, because in week 5, we are going to run central payments. And unless you do configuration of payments, invoices will not come from ECC to S4, they will fail. And then you will not be able to make payment from CFIN system. Yeah. So it is end to end. You have to, so it will cover your S/4HANA finance plus CFIN scenario. And you don't need to node ECC, because ECC, there is a limited role. There are 2 things. First is ECC, we just do CFIN related config. ECC already have data and config done. So you don't need to configure ECC brand new. Reason, in any project you go, ECC systems are up and running, right? So you don't need to worry about ECC systems. Only system you need to worry about is S/4HANA. So we will configure S/4HANA. ECC already have company codes, already have data. We will just bring that data into CFIN and we can post few transactions. And the good part is, if the knowledge curve for some of you is less, some of you is high. So then when you come in a group as a work as a team, it balances it out. So if somebody is strong in AP, somebody is strong in AR, you share that knowledge. And time slot, there is a question. Yes, there is a weekend session. Time slot is generally Saturday, Sunday. We start around 2 p.m. Central European time, which is 8 a.m. U.S. time, and 6:30 p.m. India time. Yes, you can. In ECC, everything is configured, right? MMSG integration. So you can run the entire scenario in ECC, like you create purchase order, you create good receipt, it will come to CFIN. You create invoice, it will come to CFIN. So ECC is fully configured and data is there. That is why, and that's how you get in the real business environment, because ECC are productive who are implementing S4HANA. So yes, you can see the flavors of, you can post intercompany movement, good movement from company US to Germany, and that data will come into S4. Yeah.
On AR front, are we also going to cover the special GL transactions like your down payments and incoming payments?
Down payment, yes. We have a plan to cover down payments because down payment is a specific CFIN scenario. Yes.
Okay. Yeah. On
again, Manish here. Help me to understand the difference ECC and S4HANA, especially from the CFIN perspective, because you're referring the ECC is up and running. And then because I have a scenario now that we are moving to S4 and then we will plug in CFIN future as well. So help me to understand how these steps happens.
Okay, let me come to that.
I mean, not technically, but just as from a logical perspective.
Yes, yes. So let me cover this. This is this slide, and it will clarify all the questions from that aspect.
Yeah, perfect. Got it.
Yeah. First is you are today on Oracle or ABC non-SAP system, and you want to jump to S4HANA. You do the greenfield implementation a traditional way, which everybody of you, I'm sure you are experienced. You implement past, you implement ECC. You do fresh configuration, you do testing, and you do data migration. That is greenfield. Another scenario is you do migration. In migration, what you do, you change your database from on ECC from Oracle to S4HANA, and then you run the migration cockpit, which standard SAP gives. It is within system movement. It does not involve separate installation. Step number two, which is again scenario number two. And the third scenario is central finance. When central finance is useful or should be used, when in your landscape, you have, let me show you that. Yes. When in your landscape, you already have different ECC systems or non-SAP systems, or even S4HANA, I have seen customers are using, and you have several different ERP systems. Now you want to bring together the data into one. So what you do, those systems are already running. They are productive. Business is already operating on, let's say, ECC and Oracle. What you do fresh installation of S4. You do configuration of S4HANA Finance, which, as I said, companies, GL, AR, AP, all those configurations. And then you connect those systems through central finance, which is SLT and the configurations. Then what will happen, any data being posted in ECC or in a non-SAP system will come in real time to S4HANA. So that is a central finance scenario where there is no limitation on left-hand side that there are can be a number of systems, one or two. I have worked with a customer, 25 ECC systems were replicating into one S4HANA. I have seen a customer which is now implementing, they have 88 systems, 88, which includes, I think, 35 ECC and other non-SAP, which includes Oracle, JD Edward, BAN, QuickView, several other systems. So now they are connecting all those systems into one S4. So you keep their business running in ECC, you connect, you bring the data into S4, and your data replication will start, and you will see all the data, financial data in S4. You will get your reports. You can run central payment in one cent system rather than paying from 20 systems. You make a payment from one system, and then on a S4, top of S4, you can implement group reporting. You can implement cloud analytics cloud so that your transaction data is simplified. So that's central finance. That's how the business case is. Does that make sense? And that's why I said ECC in our case, we are assuming that ECC business is already running. So we have ECC system pre-configured with data. We just need to implement brand new S4HANA, configure it, and start bringing that data from ECC into S4 by running central finance via SLT. And we have SLT system as well, which of course we have to configure. And we configure this entire scenario of initial load and real-time replication. Does that make sense?
Yeah, so Nitin, you will cover the SLT activities as well.
Exactly, exactly. We will cover SLT configuration. Current, it's a blank box. We have to configure ECC and S4HANA via SLT. SLT is SAP Landscape Transformation, which is a middleware tool by SAP. So there is a question, what is SLT? It's a middleware tool by SLT, which helps in transforming, reading the data from source, transforming it, and putting the data into S4. So it's a real-time, it's a tool which should helps in data movement.
But one question, does it mean that you have to keep different system up and running, like ECC, non-subsystems, SLT, and so on? Or you can migrate everything to S4?
Yes, that's a very good question. And that's how your journey looks like, if you see my screen. First thing is you start, so this is a transformation journey, and every large company, I can give 10 company big organizations, I'll give you names right away, which have done this way. First is a very small box, the S4HANA CFIN, you start replicating from your SAP or non-SAP data, financial data into S4HANA CFIN. Then once your data replication is good, then you implement finance, which includes payments, which includes credit management, which includes reconciliation, which includes your financial postings, everything in S4HANA. So that now your ECC systems or source systems are only used for logistics, but for finance, you use your S4 system. And then in the long run, when your finance is stable, you are using brand new S4 system, Fiori reporting, your group reporting is connected, your analytics cloud is connected. And then at the end, you bring your logistics process into S4 one by one. And then at the end, which is an SAP timeline, 2027, so which was 2025, then you sunset your ECC system. So rather running your so many systems, you can continue on one system. And the advantage it gives is during this journey goes for 6-7 years. Huh? So during this journey, you get an opportunity to harmonize your data, you clean your data, and to rethink about your business process. Because in ECC, you might running a customization 10 years old, but now you can do that fresh. Maybe standard SAP has given with standard way rather than you don't customize it. And then that's how the process works. So these are the steps in the transformation. We are talking about the small box, bringing the data from source system and using central finance and S4HANA system as a system of record for transaction, where we will be making payments from one system. So even if you have 40 systems as source, you can just make payment from one system. So that's how your transformation model looks like.
Nitin, this is Champion. So when you're saying that sunset of ECC and current processes means you'll be removing those systems over a period of time slowly?
Yes, it has to be removed. After 2027, SAP will stop supporting ECC systems. So it has to be decommissioned at one point. Maybe 25 or 27 or 28, whatever it is.
So yeah? The single source will be S4HANA.
Exactly. Okay, and another use case is customers want to keep this landscape of, let me show you. This landscape keep on running SLT and everything. Even they move to S4HANA because tomorrow they have mergers and acquisitions. If today, I think I have something for mergers and acquisitions as well. Yes. You see here on the left-hand side is your existing landscape. You bring everything to CFIN, but in future you are doing mergers. When you merge a company or you buy a company, that company might be an Oracle or ECC or any other S4HANA even. So then what you have to do, you still need the data in one central system. So then you connect your merged company via SLT into S4. And that's how the scenario looks. You bring all the data into S4. You do your planning, consolidation, bank integration, financial closing, exchange rates, all the processes in one system, centralize all your business operations. And you may sunset in 2027. If your transformation is not complete, you can continue for a couple of more years and you keep this scenario running for any mergers and acquisition. It will be just plug and play. You merge a company, you have there is an Oracle system, you plug and play, and then your Oracle data will come into S4. And then over a period of time after your mergers is settled, everything is fine. In that case, then you can just say, okay, now Oracle has to be decommissioned. You bring everything into S4. It depends on business processes and scenarios. But at the end, yeah, that's how the journeys are planned by the customers.
Thank you.
Anything, couple of questions from my end. What is the value add for the business? How we can pitch that they should move to central finance? What exactly the benefit they will get out of it? That's the one question. Second, from your side, what is the value add for us if we are non-SAP, let's say, if I'm coming through, let's say, Oracle or some other kind of background, so how I can, understand SAP language, because many times you will go on that.
Yeah. Good.
And is there any prerequisites for such kind of trainings you are expecting?
No. I'll come to one by one to your questions.
I mean, what I will, of course, your knowledge, wisdom, those I will get in the journey. Yeah. But at the end of the journey, how I can market myself or how I can convert that knowledge into, earnings or whatever.
Yes. Okay. So let me answer your first question, business benefits. There are now SAP is that sales SAP is already doing, but of course, you being a part of the organization, you have to know it. It's a non-disruptive migration to S/4HANA. And when you will register for training, I will show you, I have, fortunately, from a customer's indicative dollar values after implementing of central finance, how much they have saved. So yes, there is a big business case of actual commercial savings when customers have implemented S/4HANA and with CFIN. Of course, because of ECC going away, customers are starting their journey now in 2020, last already started. They are planning to set everything by 2025 or 2026 so that 27 is fine. So it's a non-disruptive approach. You just migrate to S/4HANA without disruption. First you move finance. It's a, lift and shift model. First you move finance and then you move your logistics. Process standardization. You have opportunity to compare your processes in ECC and S/4. Simplified reporting, because now you harmonize your master data. You harmonize your chart of accounts, and then of course, planning and consolidation. So yes, you have business benefits here. There are a lot of other benefits which I can list out, and I can share a lot of other decks with you. Of course, I will be sharing in future a lot of other decks where business benefit has been narrated in terms of actual dollars and in terms of days. If you have two ECC systems, you are doing closing in this much time, but if you have S/4HANA, you reduce your closing, something like this. And then the moment you reduce, you save money. That's one. Second thing, on your question of if you are from non-SAP background, it is fine. The only thing is it may require a little more efforts from you to learn the concept. But here it is more about transformation. It is more about, of course, there are technical things, but as long as you are ready to put that extra efforts in learning basic things about S/4HANA and to transform your mind and repository knowledge into your SAP concept, it should be fine. So in terms of market, you name a company, a very large, any large organization, and I can tell they are already running. 2 days back, Cargill went live with 35 systems. Unilever went live last year. Lufthansa already live, BMW already live, Toyota already running a program, and Dell going to start a program. You name a company. I was working for Heineken. They are already in mid of journey and half of them go lives are done. AB InBev, another brewery, largest brewery of the world. They are already running S/4HANA central finance programs. You name a company. They are every large organization, because they are struggling to already with their complex landscape. They are already in a big problem because of their landscape and heterogeneous systems. They are trying to simplify. So there are several companies who are, and it is mostly for the large companies who are very much aggressive in mergers acquisitions. Sony, like for example, Sony Pictures already did their transformation 3 years back. Stanley Black & Decker is now matured on S/4HANA, CFIN. They were the first customer in the world who implement central finance. So there are a lot of customers already worldwide. You will see there are several projects running for CFIN. So there is a good market opportunity, good scope. Now Gulf is starting CFIN. I know 3-4 emails I received already that in Gulf, a lot of big companies are starting central finance. So yes, there are big market scope for CFIN, of course, and there are benefits, and SAP is pitching these benefits to the customer. The only thing is what you need to do is just keep yourself open for learning, and it should be easy. And if you know Oracle, as I said, Oracle is second software after ECC, which is number next in scope for every organization is running some or other thing in Oracle. So yes, you have scope there to fit in. Explaining your knowledge that you have SAP, you have Oracle. You are the best fit. I have seen companies struggling with this combination of SAP and Oracle knowledge. Okay.
So what I understood that you are saying that Fortune 100 companies are going through this transformation journey towards CIFIN, and you expect that after learning CIFIN or after certification in CIFIN, the market is good as a consultant to pitch in.
It's a huge market. I'm telling you, it's a huge market. I have already done 5 projects. You can imagine in the last 3 years, already on 6th one and planning for 7th one in parallel. So you can imagine a number of projects we already have in the market.
Okay. So yeah, thanks for clarifying. So basically there is a value for learners from your side. There is a value for business benefits, which we can use it and explain it within the organization.
Yes.
And yeah, the scope is, I mean, the transformation is just started. So there is still long way to go.
Very long way. Very long way. This technology CIFIN will still at least will survive for this decade, huh? Till 2028, 2029. This decade, it is going to be the top one because every company is going to run through transformation.
Got it. Thank you.
Okay.
Nitin, are we also covering this asset accounting part for transformation?
In S4, no. We will cover overview how ECC assets is transformed into S4. But currently, till 2020, SAP asset accounting is not supported by CIFIN. In 2021, the end of this year, the release is coming. SAP is coming with central asset management. So, of course, it's a future story. But for now, we will cover how asset accounting in ECC is transformed into S4 via central finance, given the condition that CIFIN does not support asset accounting in a standard way.
Okay, so the situations or probably scenarios like, you know, asset acquisition, depreciation, you know, both plan and plan, sell of asset, which is basically discarding with revenue outside group. All are we going to cover in this particular program?
Of course, we can cover as much as the batch pick the speed. Yes, it is good. You post all those transactions in ECC and that you will see how it get replicated in S4. Yes. But in S4, we can't do anything because asset accounting is not supported in by standard CIFIN.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. So we will be covering this. So that's how standard SAP CIFIN replicates. It replicates your cost objects, internal orders or orders, FICO postings, CO postings, ECPCA commitments, activity rate, material cost estimate and projects. This is current scope of latest version 2020. That's all about replications, and it use different technologies. For accounting documents, it use SLT. For others, it use ALE, and for controlling document, cost object, profit center, and all those. That's why SLT component is very, very important because everything is covered by SLT, most of the thing. So it replicates all these objects. And then I will also be discussing this. This is what very important component, and there is no expertise, no knowledge in the market, how non-SAP systems are covered. This is all interface given by standard SAP, how non-SAP systems are integrated to SAP. When I say, I just mentioned Oracle or JD Edwards or anything else, Microsoft Dynamics Navision. So yes, there is a component on the right side, which is S4HANA SLT, but on the left-hand side, you have a non-SAP system. SAP to SAP connection is easy because you just have to map BUKRS company code is mapped to same company code or a different company code, but yes, you have an object same, but in Oracle, you have complete different data design. So I will be talking in detail about this. Of course, we can't show, we can't cover this in terms of training because we don't have this product available. This is a standard proprietary product by SAP. But yes, I will be covering in deep depth how this entire process looks like. This is a big architecture. Okay. Then we will talk about how CIFIN system can be used for business processes. As I just mentioned, you have source system up and running, but tomorrow, for example, you have a small company to acquire and you say, guys, rather than using their source, let's just migrate that small company into S4. Yes, you can do that. So if you, in this scenario, you see there is a company which is already replicating to S4.0.0.0.1, but second company directly transacting FICO, MMS, DPP in the same box. So yes, it is possible. And that's how the, we will work it out, how that is feasible. That's the end state. Just as we were talking about what should be the transformation journey and how organizations are transforming in the next 5 to 7 years. You have ECC system, you have S4HANA, and then when you start replication, slowly and gradually you see your processes move from left-hand side to right-hand side. They are moving AP, AR, GL, and everything, closing, reporting, everything moves to right-hand side at the end of the day. So you move your financial processes from left to right, and this is how you actually, jump on to transformation. So first is replication. This is the second box, which you remember I was just showing you that picture. Three circles. This is the second circle that you replicate all your processes in S4. In you're running transactions in S4 like here. On the right side, intercompany allocation, GL, planning, reporting, consolidation. And then the third box will be on top of this, you implement logistics. So that's the sensefin journey. This we discussed. We will talk about infrastructure components, end-to-end sensefin journey. How sensefin projects look like, what should be the testing strategy, how do we test it, what are the unique, what when we say unique test strategy for sensefin, what is that exactly? We will discuss that as well.
So this is Champion. The question I do have is, when we are migrating from non-SAP or SAP system, it will be keep on running till the parallel processing will take place in sensefin. How does it work?
So first step is you start replication. So once you start replication, then of course document your business will be running in ECC, and then you start getting data into S4. Then, because today you are doing your payments in ECC, then tomorrow you will do payments in S4. So you lift and shift your finance processes. So of course, you will do payment once only, but you're not in ECC, rather in S4. So you bring your processes slowly and gradually into S4 through this.
Okay, there might be a timeline fixed, like when the customer wants to ship
Exactly. I have seen customers who are just replicating from last 2 years. They want to see the data quality. And I have seen a customer who just went live with the data replication. And in next 2 months, they were already in process. In next 2 months, they started making payments in from S4 for three of their operating companies.
So their legacy system was kept up running in the meantime, right?
Yes, okay. Yes. Yeah.
Got it. Thanks.
Okay.
It's overall a ERP system whereby once it is confirmed or once it is accepted, they can start shutting the ECC or non-ERP system and use it.
Exactly. Okay. Just a different approach of moving from one system to other, rather than in one weekend, you just migrate everything into S4. It's just a slow approach, which gives a comfort to business as well. Okay, if my finance data is stable, I'm comfortable and I can use that system because I have reconciled my data.
Yeah. Thank you.
We will be discussing the test strategy. As I mentioned, it is a little bit different. We are using source production systems in testing, which is recommended by standard SAP, but why and how, that is the part of this will be the first session, which we talk about theoretically. We will talk about initial load. What is initial load? Initial load is like, if you are taking data from past month for 6, 7, 8 months, whatever month, we will run. You have an option of running initial load in SAP. And then you start replication on certain date when your system goes live, and then the data comes real time. So we will covering, we are actually going to configure and run these programs so that, we see the data coming from ECC into S4, and then we start posting new documents in ECC. It will be getting replicated to S4. We will also talk about empty initial load. There is a technology in SAP which says empty initial load. You don't bring any data. There are reasons to do that, but yes, we will be covering those. Yes. And as I mentioned, staging tables, we will cover in detail how to use staging table, what data is stored in which table at that where what point, and how to clean that table, because at the end of the journey, these tables keep on accumulated. So we will clean those tables. Any questions?
Are we going to have a detailed information about the tables that is within the S4HANA? I mean, which data, which field is basically applicable?
Yes.
For S4HANA system.
Yes.
Okay. Is there any standard material that you, or probably a material that you?
Yeah, we have that material. We'll share that. Yeah. Okay. Standard SAP books or standard SAP guides, which are available. Yeah.
Is that something you can show how CFIN system looks like?
I could have shown in different laptop. It's a S4HANA system, normal S4HANA system. There is no difference in ECC or S4. Yeah, it's a normal S4 system, but we just activate CFIN IMG. There is a separate, within SPRO, there is a new node added. And then, yeah, there we do the configurations.
And we need to know the T codes in that case?
You don't need to know any T code, just CFIN IMG. That's if you know that that's all is used in CFIN.
Okay.
Yes. That takes you directly to the CFIN configurations menu, and you directly start using that. In that, only CFIN configuration nodes are given.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, there is a chat, I think.
Anything. I still have a lot of questions, but I think in the view of time and for all of us, it doesn't make sense that I have those questions. So will it be possible to have a short call whenever you are free today?
You can give me a call. There is a, on the right-hand side, you can see there is a WhatsApp. Just add me on the WhatsApp and yes, we can chat and then we can call. Yeah.
Yeah, because before I register, before I make my mind, I want to understand.
Yeah, sure. No problem. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. And there is a question, in real time, if SLT configuration comes under functional role or technical role, ideally it comes under technical role, but functional should understand, because putting filters and putting all those, you know, functional thing in SLT will always be a functional role. So basis will help you in connecting systems, but explaining them what filters, how to put those filters and what is the use of that filter is something all functional. So that's why I mentioned SLT is there. We will do configuration and we will show you all the how to put the standard filters and custom filters, so that if something, if you need in your role, yeah, that will be helpful. Yeah. Any other question I can help you with? A quick one. Or you still have any doubt? As I mentioned, this will not be a PowerPoint training. This is purely a system-based training. You will be working in the system. You have to spend some time. I'm very direct. You have to spend some time, not in training, but rather offline as well. Let's say 2 hours a week, 3 hours a week, depends on your schedule. Any day, just offline. Let's say if you are doing any configuration or if you are going through something. So yes, your efforts are required offline as well.
Okay. So if that is the case, how it is coordinated among the trainees, like who's going to do what and how?
Yes. So when we start the work, we assign work to everybody. But during the week, when we are not, of course, not meeting, then we have a WhatsApp group for everybody in the batch. We coordinate by a WhatsApp. And documentation is shared via Google Drive. So anybody, let's say if there just this morning, there was a person who implemented notes. He said, yeah, I have completed 5 notes. This is a manual step. Can you do this? He just messaged and he updated the Excel file on the Google Drive so that, you know, we know what notes are implemented, what is happening. So we collaborate through WhatsApp group with each other so that we keep on aligned, that if he's done his task of creating company code and next person, for example, has to do number range, he knows, okay, guys, I have done my company code. 1000, can you complete the number in part and let me know so that I can carry with the, let's say, unit test. Yeah. So we collaborate through WhatsApp group.
Okay. So you're saying this strong collaboration will not allow people to create multiple companies, multiple configuration of the same activity. Correct?
Exactly. Okay. Exactly. Yeah.
That sounds good.
Yeah. Anything else? Any other question? So, and you will have system access. As soon as you register, you will have system access, plus during training and after the training, 30 days, system is with you. Of course, we don't expect you to break things. Otherwise, you know, everybody is using the system in your batch. So we don't expect you to break the system, but of course, you know, use it carefully. System will be with you. You can run scenario, you can test it, you can learn it. It will be with you for that purpose.
Okay, when is the batch starting?
Batch is starting in, I think, next week I think the plan is to have first session next week. And there are already few people registered. So just a request to everybody, if you are really planning, immediately register and I will arrange everything. All accesses will be given to you in 24 hours so that you get the flavor of the system as well. And you will get to read the material in advance so that, you know, you are already comfortable when you join the class in a week or so. All these books will be available in PDF format with you to read on the Google Drive. You can download it. It's all PDF. S4F04 is an old material now for 1909 and 2020. S4F60, S4F61 is available. Entire books are there. You will just get access to the books. Along with there are several other guides, I didn't mention this. There is a new tool by SAP, which is still not out in the market, Configuration Harmonization Engine, CHE. What is that? That tool is basically, if you have multiple ECC systems and you have one S4HANA, of course, as the scenario is, how do you ensure that configuration on source side is aligned with configuration on target side? For example, I created a new company code in ECC, and I just started posting document because I am not aware what is happening on the central system. I am sitting in one small country, my system. So then that tool takes care of creating that configuration in S4 side as well, rather than everything get into errors and documents are in error. So there is a brand new tool, not yet available in the market, but I will give you a guide and a preview how that configuration harmonization engine looks like. Along with that, SLT is very important component. There is a guide, but yeah, we will cover step by step. And as I said, all recording will be there. Even if you miss a session or if you miss, you are already discussing with the group on WhatsApp. But if you want to see something later, how that config was done or what was the topic, you have the video link. You can just browse over YouTube. You will get a private video link.
So if I skip this batch, so when will be the next batch start as such?
It depends. Currently, one is already running. Second one is already planned. So I don't know what are the time frame for the third one. I would say if you can, go for the next one.
Okay. Thank you.
Hi. Is there any flexibility to join other batches also if I skip any of the classes?
Yes. So yes, there is a flexibility. Yeah. So for example, you join the second batch and you think you missed somehow a couple of classes, but you want to recover that because the format is same. So yes, those two classes, you can jump onto other batch. Yeah, just to ensure that you are well aware. Yes.
Thank you.
So how many people are there in your team? Like you are the only person going to go?
I am the only one who take training. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Because I have worked on projects, so I know the real situation, real-time scenarios. And if I assign somebody, that does not make sense. Yeah.
Got it. Thank you.
Yeah. And yes, so if something is missed, yes, you have opportunity to cover in the next sessions. Yes.
Okay. And what is the mode of payment like? Whether it needs to be done to bank transfer?
Which country you are in?
US.
US, you can do, I can give you a US bank account. You can do bank transfer or PayPal. Both are okay.
Okay, got it.
Okay. In case you have any other questions, you have an email ID at the bottom. You have WhatsApp on the right-hand side. There is a QR. Just scan it and drop me a message. I will be happy to answer the questions. And tomorrow, there is a free webinar coming in for Central Finance Architecture. Feel free to join it.
And there is a link for that.
It is on LinkedIn already in the event section.
Okay.
Yes.
And what time it is?
It is, I think it is same time. Yeah,
same time.
Exactly.
Okay.
Same time. Yeah. And in the meanwhile, I will fix my Zoom. What happened? I don't know.
Yeah. Take care.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you. Okay. I appreciate that, Nitin.
Nitin, let's call. Call. I want to just conclude ASAP.
Yes, you can call me in 10 minutes before I jump to the batch.
Sure. Yeah?
Yes, you have a WhatsApp number. Just give me a call. Yeah, we can connect. Sure. Thank you.
Thanks.
Hey, Nitin, sorry, I don't see your WhatsApp number.
It is there on the, you see on the right-hand side, there is a QR code. Just scan it.
Oh, okay.
You can scan before I stop sharing.
Hi, Nitin. What are the payment modes from India?
India is directly bank transfer in INR.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, NEFT, yeah. Okay, so you can, any other question if you think like payment mode or how to communicate, so you have an option of WhatsApp or email, both, just feel free to communicate on any channel. Yeah. And yeah, thank you so much. I will put this recording as well on YouTube and I will share the link after with you all. Yeah, thank you so much.